Hey guys, John from John's DIY Playground. Today I want to show you some Moteinos. I use them in my home automation system, but you can use them for different types of programs where you want to have two-way communication. It's a really nice device. It's Arduino-based and it has a radio transceiver included on it. So I have three different types here, and I have this FTDI connector. So FTDI is needed for most of the Moteinos. In order to flash them or to talk to them on a routine basis, like if you're going to have them plugged into a Raspberry Pi gateway. So I have just one of these, and I usually use them to flash all my different Moteinos, at least the first time. Then you can program wirelessly. Then, after that, if you need something more full-time USB, you can buy a Moteino USB, as it's called, with the FTDI chip on it. I use that for my Raspberry Pi gateway module, and then I don't need this FTDI. It's very nice. This is the base Moteino here on the lower left. It's the least expensive of all the Moteinos. And I'll show you how to choose what type of Moteino. Basically, they have analog digital inputs. The Moteino Mega has a lot more than the base Moteino and a bigger chip as well. And it also has, on the Moteino Mega, the option for an external antenna. Okay, so here we are at the lowpowerlab.com/shop URL. And you can see it's the web store. There's many good products here. They've all been developed and customized by Felix at the Low Power Lab shop. PC board quality is excellent. All the parts that I've received I've never had any problems with. They know they're functionally tested. Component placements, all that looks great. So as I mentioned before, we've got the base Moteino here that we'll get into in a second, the Moteino Mega and the Moteino USB. In the future videos, if you subscribe, I will plan to also do a switch mote review and how to put that together and this motion LED kit. So that's in the plans for the future. FTDI adapter, you also need that, like I said, for first time programming. And then if you want to order a Moteino, let me show you some of the important things about that. So when you do order, you have to choose what transceiver you want. And in my case, I always use an RFM69HW. I choose the HW because it's got the ability to do a high power output. It costs a little bit more, but it's something that I was interested in. You can't go wrong either with this 433 megahertz HW, but keep in mind, whenever you start ordering these, you're kind of locked in because you have to stick with the same frequency on the transmitter and receiver, obviously. So choose a frequency based on what you think you need. So other than transceiver, you also need to choose if you want flash memory. Now, the important part about that is this flash memory chip would go right here on the board. You definitely should just spend the extra $3 to get the flash memory, I would say, because the flash memory is what allows you to do wireless programming. So after you program the first time over FTDI, the flash memory will allow the program that you're going to flash into the chip to come in and sit on this EEPROM, and then the EEPROM will flash the Moteino. It's a really cool feature. I highly recommend it. And then finally, the headers. It's only $1, and they come with both sides and the FTDI connection point. So that's what comes in a kit. In addition, you also get the proper length antenna that you'll have to solder on here, and I'll show you how to do that shortly. Just to add a little bit more information for you about the RFM69 radios, you can see the W is the standard and the HW is the higher power output. It definitely comes at a cost for TX power consumption when you're transmitting on the base 45 milliampers versus the high power output is 130 milliampers. So if you were thinking of a project that needs to run on battery power, you might consider trying to get away with the 69W instead of the HW. Then if you take a look over here at this the guide, it's showing how the radios, these RFM69 transceivers, are married on the underside of the Moteinos. There's many different options. In addition to the 69H and HW, there's these LoRa modules also that are higher power and very long range. This shows you some of the antenna options you can use with the Moteino Mega version. And there's the external connector we talked about. Finally, for our project today, our demonstration, we have a Moteino, I guess base you would call it, the base module. We need to keep in mind when we do any of our programming to visit this Moteino pinout area. Very important, because what's interesting to know is that the transceiver has to use certain pins in order to talk to the transceiver. Normally, if you don't get a transceiver, you can use all of the pins for analog and digital input output, but when you have that transceiver, keep in mind that the certain pins you cannot use. So for example, digital 2 and digital 10, 11, 12, and 13 are all used by the transceiver no matter which one you choose. And if you do have this flash chip, in order to use that, it's also using digital 8 and then 11 through 13. So those are pins you do not want to use for anything else, and just leave them dedicated as keep outs so that the transceiver can do its job. All right, guys, so that does it for today's Moteino introduction. Hopefully you found one that interests you. If you do go with a Moteino USB and one of these regular Moteinos, in the upcoming lessons, as part of a three-part series, I'm going to show you in part two how to put the Moteino together, and then in part three how to program it and set it up with your home automation system. So please give a thumbs up if you liked it, and if you're interested in the future videos from me, please hit the subscribe button. This is John from John's DIY Playground. Have a great day.